Let us try to construct a semantic network representation for this guards and prisoners problem and see how we can use it to do the problem solving. So in this representation, I'm going to say that each node is a state in the problem solving. In this particular state, there happens to be one guard and one prisoner on the left side. The boat is on the right side, and two prisoners and two of the guards are also on the right side. So this is a node, one single node. So the node captured the lexicon of the semantic network. Now we'll add the structural part, and the structural part has to do with the transformation. That is going to connect different nodes into a more complex sentence. We'll label the links between the nodes, and these labels then will capture some of the semantics of this representation that will allow us to make interesting inferences when it comes time to do the problem solving. Here is the second node, and this node represents a different state in the problem solving. In this case, there are two guards and two prisoners on the left side. The boat is also on the left side, and there is one guard and one prisoner on the right side. So this now is a semantic network, a node, another node, a link between them, and the link is labeled. Note that in this representation, I used icons to represent objects, as well as icons to represent the labels on the links between the nodes. This is perfectly valid. You don't have to use words. You can use icons. As long as you're capturing the nodes and the objects inside each state, as well as the labels on the links between the different nodes.